John, today was a big day at WGN for your friend and mine, Wally Phillips. The day that Wally opened, revealed the name that he had kept locked up in a little black box for 8 years. It all began as an experiment born of Wally's skepticism of the powers of would-be psychics. But it turned into a mystery, which was solved this morning as Bob Sirott watched.
I was reading some of Gene Dixon's predictions of things to come, and I thought, what nonsense. And Irene Hughes and the other soothsayers were telling us of disasters of that year, and I thought, gee, this is silly. They do this every year, and nobody checks to see if they're any good.
The most popular radio program in Chicago ended its 8-year mystery this morning. The only clue to the name on a piece of paper in the safe had been that it was a living person. Wally offered anyone with the answer a cash prize. He had been adding a dollar a day. By today, the right name is worth almost $4,000. Some mornings, he would actually turn the lights down, think of the name, and try to telepathically send it to a listener. No one got the message until this morning.
Would you please step in here to this microphone now and give us your name?
Gene Rogers.
Gene who, you ask? Maybe you remember Gene Rogers best in the old Flash Gordon serials. She was Dale Arden.
What has become of Flash Gordon? Please.
You will never see the Earthman again, but you will not miss him. Soon you will forget him forever.
Wally picked Gene Rogers as his mystery name because she was well-known in a way, but almost unguessable, unless, of course, you had psychic powers. Also, Wally was one of the millions of young boys captivated by the lovely sight of Dale Arden.
What are you doing to Flash?
Look.
Gene Rogers wasn't easily rescued from obscurity by Wally Phillips. He had to enlist the services of private eye Dennis Burke, who found her in California. Wally even talked to Flash Gordon this morning. Buster Crabb, he's now living out in Arizona. Charles Middleton, who played Ming, and Frank Shannon, Dr. Zarkoff, have both passed away. But Gene Rogers, Dale Arden, she's doing fine.
Sort of retired now. A little while back, I was in the newspaper business with my friend Ray. I enjoyed that. But
are you surprised by all of this fuss about Flash Gordon? I mean, my God, it's almost 50 years old. Are you surprised at the staying power of that serial?
Yes, I in a way I am, but in a way I'm not. I just sort of hard for you to explain. When Buster and I, he thought they were crazy to make it, and I had to do it because I was under contract. But when you're under contract, you have to do what they tell you to do. And I thought, oh, gee, this is pretty insane.
Gene Rogers only made $50 a week back then in 1936. No wonder she was screaming all the time. Flash and Dale haven't been together since then, but they kept in touch over the years. Gene Rogers says Buster Crabb, who's 74 now, calls her regularly, and they do see each other occasionally. Although Flash Gordon never did get that first on-camera kiss from Dale Arden, I guess he never gave up. By the way, all the money Wally Phillips got in the jackpot over the years will be donated now to Chicago's neediest children's Christmas fund. And Bill and Walter, mystery still unsolved. How did Flash get out of the octopus tank?
So hers was the name in the box and nobody did guess it.
Nobody ever
guessed
it.
Why did Wally decide to release it today?
He said he thought people were starting to get bored with the whole idea of it and he wanted to move on to a new project.
Of course, it really says something about those psychics, right? I mean, you'd think they'd have been trying. Not one of them worked in 8 years.
Well, it was a small box. Yeah.
The question really is tonight, did the great Gretzky break the record? Johnny will have the answer when we come back.